some of these videos, it starts too early. It's actually not that early. It's like 5:50. Racing down to Santa Ana. The earlier I get there, the earlier I'm hoping I can leave. The reason I'm going to Santa Ana is I'm linking up with my buddy, Greg. Some of y'all know him by Greg. But no, Instagram is wired by Greg. He actually just started his Instagram, even though he's done most of the trucks that are here in California that a lot of you see day to day. From AJ's truck to Jason's truck to, I mean, you name it. Did my Tundra. Tundra is a lot of work. This Raptor won't be that much. So, yeah. A lot of people are at the Offroad Expo today and tomorrow. I'm going to try and probably go there tomorrow. I need to spend some time with my wife. And I need to get some sleep. So, yeah. See you guys when I get there.
Sunsets in the sky, going out, staying in, staying up all night. I'm waking up alone, wishing I can move on, but you'll know.
Hi, Greg. Tired.
What?
Yeah.
I have an extra room.
You
can take a nap.
I'm gonna take a nap. Everyone that doesn't know, that's Greg.
Hi.
He goes by Wired by Greg.
What's up?
He's done my Tundra. He's doing the Raptor.
Heck yeah. Let's get it done.
Yeah, it needs to be done today.
That's fine with me. That's cool.
What's your company name, Greg?
Wired by Greg.
Yeah, what do you do?
Wire anything with battery, four wheels. I'll even do two.
Did two wheels? I got a two wheeler for you.
We won't go there yet.
Okay.
But we'll let the two-wheel guys do the two-wheel
thing. So where are you located?
Santa Ana, California.
And how long have you been doing wiring?
Longer than I had a driver's license.
It's probably longer than I've been alive.
Don't make me feel that old.
but you do like major stuff, like casinos, that kind of stuff?
Yeah. So my Monday through Friday gig is audio integration. So we do everything from 100-inch screens or bigger, speakers, amp racks. We like to crawl in the ceilings and get dirty and run data cables. So we pretty much do everything. So
ton of wiring.
Anything wiring involved, I do it.
Sweet. And then what got you into doing off-road trucks?
I don't know who's responsible for that, but I've just always been into cars. The Wired by Greg really was like a joke. I think someone like said hashtag Wired by Greg one day, so that kind of stuck. But I kind of did my own car audio thing back in the day. I had a mini truck like every other guy with the Tacoma. It's been fun.
And most of your primary customers, are they from the off-road overland space?
Majority of them now are off-road overland, but I do see a little bit of track stuff. So a lot of the guys like to do the LED lighting on it, underglow, engine bay lighting, stuff that makes it easier to work on your car.
Got it. And now we're going to name drop. What are some notable rigs that you have worked on?
Ooh, the Taco Dust rig.
Taco Dust rig. I actually said that when I was driving out here. I said that you've done Jason's truck, done AJ's truck.
Yep. Your Tundra.
My Tundra.
The Vilmont Cruise.
The Vilmont Cruise stuff.
Some Goose Gear equipment.
Yeah.
Trying to think. Oh, the Leitner guys.
Yeah.
Taking care of all the Leitner guys now.
Good old Bernard. Love that dude.
Joe at SoCal.
So basically everyone and everyone.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So.
That's cool.
It's been fun. Yeah. Fun ride.
Cool. So. Well, what are we going to do first?
Well, I think today we're going to start on the rear of the truck. We're going to go ahead and do the SRMs and kind of work from the back to the front. Since there's less work on the rear, we'll go ahead and do that.
So we'll do the SRMs, mount the SDHQ chase light brackets, mount the chase lights, and then how's the best way that we're going to run the wiring? We're going to run it between the bed and the cab and then all the way up underneath?
I don't know. This one...
Figure it out as we go.
Yeah. We'll. I don't want to give all the secrets away now.
Oh, that's true. Well, don't give any secrets because then people are going to take your job. It's like what Chris D'Elia said. You afraid the alligators will take your job? Then wear shoes. See these shoes? I bought them. I'm an independent woman.
Number 6-inch. So we're just under 10 amps. So that's pretty much what we want to do. So you'll have your 3/4 on each side. I'll check with Ford just to make sure it works, and then we'll go from there.
These are some D-Series SAE DOTs. Pretty sweet. Those are all four going in behind the lower grill. We have two chase lights. One, two, both ambers. Those are going above the bed. We got some SRM Pros that we're going to be using as a backlight, a backup light kit. That's it. And I have like another chase light. That's going to be for the third brake light, rock lights. That's it. Let's get started, hey? It's pretty nifty. Is Ford has, what do they call them, upfitter switches?
Yes.
Upfitter switches. Still trying to get the lingo down, but basically, I'm gonna be running those. I think we're running five of them. Could have ran the reverse lights to the six, but we're not going to. We're just gonna tap into the actual reverse lights, so should be fun. Then we gotta drill some holes for the SDHQ mounts. Hopefully Greg has a steady hand today.
What is that?
This is the SRM for reverse.
Okay, and how'd you mount it?
No hardware, well, custom hardware needed, just the factory rigid stuff. There's a hole right next to the bumper mount, goes straight through, 13 mil on the top. Beautiful.
And we have another one obviously going on this side, and then those get connected to the reverse lights.
Yes, sir.
So we're gonna go tapping.
Reverse. So that's gonna be super simple. It's probably one of the easiest kits I've installed to date.
Well, we're doing the easy stuff first.
Mark center for our chase lights. Basically, we're gonna mount the SDHQ brackets on the bed rail. So one rigid chase light will be there, and another one over here.
Super cool.
So SDHQ makes a bracket that's fairly simple and universal. But for the Raptor, it's super simple. It's gonna give us a nice mounting pad. It'll go right here. You do have to do a little bit of drilling, but it's gonna set it just perfect.
And those are ambers, so those are gonna be used as a, even though they kinda, I think they changed the rules on the chase light. I think they're green now, but yeah, so they're amber chase lights. They're gonna have, they have a reverse function, and then they also have strobe and a DRL. So they're gonna be wired as a reverse and then also have the strobe function, and then also while the truck is running, it'll have its DRL function that is very similar to the Raptor's, you know, front ambers. So yeah.
Cool. Gonna turn it
where on? Are you gonna run the wires?
Everything is gonna go straight down the back.
Okay.
Tie into the factory harness and go up to the front of the wing.
Look how clean this thing still is. Good old Shine Supply. And we got another guy mounting up the SRM Pros. Excited for this. Courtesy light underneath. So now we are making a custom bracket for these. Which is actually pretty cool because the 360s are not SADOT compliant. So the amber backlighting is on those, but the white light obviously is not, and I'm not going to be that guy. So Rigid really did a really good job with, English is serious, with their SADOT line. And you can get the 360s in that. You can get most of the lights with that, but I decided to do D series. They also make like little light bars with it, like the SR series. But basically these are gonna go here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And during any conditions that I want to have a little extra light, especially with the, they call this selective yellow. So it's not really an amber, but it looks amber. Any conditions like snowy, fog, rain, that kind of stuff where I feel like I need a little extra light, that's what these are gonna be for, and they're just gonna be mounted right here. And completely legal to run during the day. They actually make a white light as well. See, SADOT. So yeah, make a bracket. It's gonna mount, where is it? I can't see it. It's gonna mount back here, go all the way across, and we're gonna mount these little suckers to it. And I keep saying we, I mean they. So we're gonna get some metal that's over there, do some bending. Yeah. So all the wiring is being ran to the back right now. It's gonna be done in some snakeskin. I don't know what any of this says, but this is the wiring for the chase. I'm sure you guys, some of you guys can understand it better than I. But, so can I wire my own lights? Probably can. I've done it in the past. However, professionals, if you have the ability to utilize your resources and having professionals do the installs of certain products, especially when it comes to like wiring, suspension is huge, have them do it, because why not? A little bit more reassurance, especially when it's electrical, because I can catch my stuff on fire, not trying to burn down my brand new truck. So yeah.
Noticeable with the bed liner.
Yeah, they actually do a really good job with the bed liner, the factory does.
That's gorgeous. I thought that was
aftermarket. Oh, I thought you were talking about me. SDHQ chase light brackets are mounted. This is the best thing ever. It's probably one of my most favorite things about the truck. Like loading the bike with that step there. Money! All the wiring is getting snake skinned up over there. Working back to front, back to front. Rigid chase lights installed, or mounted. Still waiting to, just gonna have to wire them. And then, yeah. All right, so what are we doing?
Making your harness that goes to the rear for your rear, reverse lights. We got an extra wire connected to it.
And the chase lights too.
Yeah, the chase lights as well. Right now I'm just putting on the snake skin. That way it looks nice and clean under the vehicle.
And what does snake skin exactly do for your wiring?
It protects it from any damages physical wise. Right now these wires also have like heat shielding in it.
Okay.
So that protects it from heat as well. And
so it's just an extra precaution, make it cleaner.
Yeah. Cleaner look and more protection on the wires.
Sweet.
So.
What you doing?
We're gonna go ahead and mount a Blue Sea grounding terminal block so we can send all the negatives from the lights up to somewhere versus grouping them all on a like a fender bolt or the battery terminal. Just to tidy things up.
Yeah, because a lot of people just said earlier they'll bunch them up all on that.
Yeah. So that'll give you a cover. I have a 4-gauge wire that'll go from here up to the battery. All your grounding terminals come to here, label everything. That way, if it ever gets modified, everyone will know what we're doing.
There you go.
Daniel, could you clamp me on that side?
Yeah,
cool.
A little test fit action.
Cool.
Is it gonna work?
Yeah.
It's gonna work well.
If not, can't see it from my house.
Attention to detail. Greg, what are you doing?
We are mounting the bracket that we
El Custimo bracket is how they say it.
Yes,
El Custimo. In French. In French. So yeah, that's gonna hold the four D series.
Oh no shit! He did that for me?
Alright. Bracket's done. Grill going back on. No, it's because the clip is over. Alright, now let's push switch number uno, which is a pillar, which are insanely bright. Now those are backlit with the fogs. And then, on top of it, I'm gonna go ahead and hit switch 5. Switch 5 is SRM Pros diffused. Nifty. Last thing we need to wire, these little suckers. So these are ambers. Basically what we're gonna do is it has a DRL, which is a low light amber, which is gonna run with the DRLs of the truck. And then it has a strobe function, and then also in the center, it is reverse light, so getting there. How do you feel, Greg?
I'm doing phenomenal.
Phenomenal?
We're getting there.
Getting there.
We are getting there. Piece by piece.
And clean.
Yes.
All about being clean. Which that obviously is not finished. Oh, let me turn the lights off. There's something satisfying about hitting switches. Something satisfying.
See, it's done.
Everything up front is actually done. Now, gotta tackle the rear.
Shouldn't be that bad.
How you doing, Simone?
All right.
What's up? Travis has his Raptor. Got a bunch of rigid lights on this bad boy. Wait till you guys see the front. Thing's pretty trick. Went ahead and made a custom bracket for the front. SAE ambers. Got 360s all over the place. Thing's pretty trick. Definitely stoked how it came out.
It's pickup day. This guy. Greg wanted to keep it overnight because he wanted to rip it around Orange County. But yeah, let me. Oh, I can't flip this around. DRLs, even though they're blinking, they're actually not. Those are wired. And then I'm gonna add actually a video of what Greg did showing all the lights on. That's gonna make my life a lot easier because it's daylight. But yeah, I gotta go drop this truck off at Camburg. Greg.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
No problem.
Can you tell people how they can find you?
You can go to Wired by Greg through Instagram. I'm also Greg underscore GM3 on my personal account. And then we have wiredbygreg at gmail.com if you have any questions. And we're working on a website.
Working on a website. So he's getting official. He got stickers already. Following that comes a website. But yeah, Greg always does great work. So if you need anything done, anything and everything, right?
Yes, sir.
Anything with wires, probably get it done for you. I don't want people's minds to go racing. Anything with wires and lights is usually, or radios,
or minor fabrication.
Yeah, minor fabrication.
If you want real welding, go see Camburg.
Yeah, cool. All right, guys, that's it. Gotta go drop this truck off. Until next time. There's the Camburg Raptor. Jason's the long travel kit. We're here at the Adventure Expo in Orange County. Let's go to the Camburg booth. He's living his best life. Living his best life. Yeah, Camburg, badass booth. Where's Jerry? Okay, all right. Gotta go find Jerry. Look at this guy, a little Mountainhatch action. What's up, dude?
Good to see you.
How are you? How's the show for you?
Good.
Good?
We sold out the first night, and then I had to go back and get more, so it was good.
Can you tell the people what you do?
We make tailgate inserts for trucks.
There we go.
Make them food safe. They're flat. You don't spill your drink anymore, and turns it into a table.
There you go.
Yep.
Super easy. Make sure you Mountainhatch on Instagram. And actually, I used to have one on my Tundra, and I used it all the time. And I have a Raptor.
We'll get you one. Later, man.
Later. It's good seeing you.
There we go.
We're here at the Adventure Expo.
It's really busy.
Jason, how are you feeling today?
I feel great. I just had an ice cream.
Okay.
I had the most generic burrito ever. They said authentic Mexican food, and it was like literally like worse.
Taco Bell?
No, worse.
Oh wow.
Like the kind where you get like the normal like mission tortillas, and then you overcook them so they're hard and they crack when you fold it.
Yeah, it's like a fried burrito.
Frozen burrito.
Yeah, better than.
Full on frozen.
What's up, long dog?
What's up, man?
How you feeling?
I'm feeling great.
We're over here at the rig booth. They make my tire carrier.
Did you see my truck in the Tacoma?
No, I haven't been inside yet.
Cleanest Tacoma.
Wow. Oh, 100%. I would agree with that.
Yeah, 100%.
So this thing's rad. Can I say what you're doing next? No? Oh, I can? It's a James Brood that's going on top of that. That's orange. Right there, behind the red one, in case you're colorblind. So, you going to come again to this show?
For sure. Like, I would rather do this show than do Overland Expo West.
But you'll be at Overland Expo West.
And East and Mountain West.
See?
And killing Northwest it. Overland Rally.
And eventually he's just going to hire me.
And huh? Sea Otter.
And what? Otter. What's Sea Otter?
Don't worry about it. See?
Well, I'm not even in the loop anymore.
Buys a bike, doesn't know.
It's the biggest mountain bike festival in the world.
Cool. Well, you guys are awesome. Great work. One of the nicest trucks here, except for this hunk of...
It's the first third gen OD green fucking Lightner wreck.
Didn't get much footage. Saying hi to all the people I'm grateful to be friends with and partners I've worked with and all that. So I'm on my way home. And I'll try and cue some footage from some other people that got some, I guess. But yeah, got the long travel Camburg Raptor behind me. Jason's son, Corey, is driving it. But 2 hour drive home and yeah, trucks at Camburg. I'm gonna be there for the next week. ADV fiberglass on these trucks, on the Raptors, absolutely nuts. Looks so good. Looks so good. That's gonna be it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, obviously ask them below. Stay pretty on top of answering them. And yeah, we'll see what's next. Can't really talk right now, I'm just exhausted.